Hi, George.
Hello, German. How are you?
Ooh, can't complain. Depressed, poor, totally shagged out.
How'd it go this morning?
Oh, it's very busy. I'd spend half the morning hiding inside a kitchen cabinet until it calmed down.
You did?
Standard of workmanship in those cabinets is incredible, you know. I mean, you expect the odd screwhead to show, wouldn't you?
You should be out there selling, pushing yourself, shouldn't he, George?
Yes, got to be aggressive.
It's simple. I'm going to turn you into a salesman. Show me what you can do. Sell that to George.
Do you want to buy this, George?
Not really.
He doesn't want to buy again.
All right, let's recreate market conditions. You're trying to sell this security device to George, who's a little old lady.
Could I be Welsh?
Eh?
I'd like to be a little old Welsh lady.
If it helps, yeah.
Am I going to be Welsh too? It always comes out Pakistani.
It doesn't bloody matter. Just do it, will you? This is for your benefit.
Madam, the impregnatron door clamp provides a second line of defense against unwelcome guests.
Well, that's a mercy.
I'll just get my assistant to show you how it works. This mobile marvel fits easily over handles, rendering the door unopenable.
Yes, thank you. I'll have one of those.
Great. So, when do you leave Wales and come to London, then?
Oh, there's quite a funny story attached to that.
Really?
Yes. We were out gathering slate and so on.
All right, you two.
Oh, I enjoyed that. Can I play it with a stutter next?
No. Dermot, have you got me the money?
Tonight, all right?
Yeah, all right. That's not bad, is it? British ingenuity. That would have taken 400 strong Japanese working round the clock to come up with an idea like that. Even the most determined intruder will have trouble in... You're like a bull in a china shop, aren't you? Ask the butcher to cut the liver into the thinnest slices possible. Crush the peppercorns in a pestle and mortar if you have one. Well, I haven't got one, Delia. Oh, if you haven't got one, use the back of a spoon.
Say that speck of dust got back into the house again.
How'd it go?
Oh, I'm knackered. I fell asleep against this woman on the bus. She was all right until we got to Oxford Circus and I started dribbling on her shoulder.
Slice that, will you? Don't tell me your new employers didn't offer you a cigar and a seat on the board.
Not for me any kind of seat. Or standing up all day fantasizing about sofas.
That makes a change from your usual fantasies about semi-naked women in bits of white underwear.
Not really. These sofas already had semi-naked women in them. They squeezed up to let me sit down.
That's your trouble. You're obsessed with sex.
It's your fault you keep on giving me suggestive food. What are you cooking, anyway?
Well, it's basically an adaptation of a Persian dish and a rather subtle juniper sauce. Followed by jelly and ice cream.
With hundreds and thousands?
Yeah.
Good. I need something to take my mind off Lisa.
Yeah.
I taught her all my best beer mat tricks, you know. Why did she leave me?
Perhaps she shouldn't have slept with her best friend.
Yeah. Women don't lie that much, do they? Her teeth went all kind of clenched, like in Dallas. Is this mine?
Nope.
Good, I'm gonna change.
We'll change it to something useful, like a curry. Hey, I think a woman's gonna move in upstairs. I found a letter addressed to someone called Deborah.
Great, what's it say?
How should I know? It's private. Actually, I did accidentally steal it over and read it. enjoyed a holiday in France, but the weather was a bit disappointing.
France, eh?
Bonjour, Deborah. Je m'appelle Dermot. I'm sensitive and artistic.
Have you got the sharp knife in there?
Yeah, it's on the side. I'll bring it out in a minute.
Yo, get down, bitch!
Dermot! Oh, I see, it's a duvet. Well, silly old me, I thought for a minute there you'd spent all the money you owe me on a new suit, you piece of scum.
I'm looking after it for a friend.
No, you're not.
Why, it's an investment.
No, it isn't. It's a bloody new bloody suit, you bastard.
It's not my fault. Whenever I see a check, I go out of control. I'm the same with tight black skirts, actually.
This is my money we are talking about here. What would you say if I emptied your wallet and went out on a spending spree?
I'd say, what can you buy these days for an old library ticket and a picture of Lisa bending down on Dalton Beach?
Shut up. And what else have you bought for yourself?
Nothing.
Well, what's in that bag?
Oh, it's a cookery book.
You expect me to believe that, do you?
You're always saying you're tired of me cooking the same thing all the time.
Yeah, all right.
Not that there's anything wrong with fish fingers sur la toast.
Take those stupid sunglasses off.